Hey folks, Species7 here, and welcome back to the second part of our little look at a logistics company. Yes, indeed. So last time we kind of mucked about in this crane here, and unloaded a few containers, saw how that got done, and had another train come in. We loaded the containers on that one, and it zoomed off, and we sort of got paid for our troubles. So, that's continues on through the tutorial. Once you're through it, though, you can see there's a few more things here opened up. That swings pretty freely. We have an administration building, a parking lot, and a transshipment point. The administration building is key to everything. If we click on it, it opens up all the available jobs. Okay. And if we click on a job, it shows you exactly what's going to need to be done. For instance, this one, on the 13th of December, a truck will arrive, and you'll want to unload two containers. And then 4 days later, on the 17th, he will come back for the two containers, and you can load them onto a different truck, and away he goes. That contract will pay out €8,200. Okay, so. And you can sort through, like here's one where we've got, ooh, I like this one, on the 13th, tomorrow, 5 train cars to unload, and then 7 days later on the 20th, you can load 5 of them back onto a new train. So that's not bad. And that pays pretty darn good, $34,000. Now what you have to keep in mind is, if you say accepted this contract, you would be kind of really busy on the 13th and kind of really busy on the 20th. The 7 days in between, you're spending money on vehicle maintenance and building maintenance, about $1,000 a day or €1,000 or whatever. So take $7,000 off that price right away, and you'll figure out approximately what you will make. So ideally, what you'd want to do would be to go, okay, I can unload this one tomorrow. If I was to take this one as well, I could unload these two cars, or these two containers from the truck. They'd be in on the 12th. See, these both run this, and then on the 17th. So you'd at least have something to do part way through the day. Right, but I think this time around we're going to what else have we got here before I just go pick 6 on a train, 6 off a train. What do we got here? See, they can get a little more complicated. Like this one wants you to take 3 of them off a train, 2 of them off a train, then 3 of them onto a train, and 2 of them onto a truck. Alright. A little kind of interesting, that one nets 37,000. But, like I said, I think, oh, not that one, because I kind of want to show you guys. There. We'll pick this nice simple one, just because mainly I want to show you guys this other piece of equipment. So we'll accept that contract, okay. Then we can go to our container stacker.
Containers move between spaces at the transshipment point using the container stacker. You can also use the container stacker to load and unload trucks.
This is our container stacker, and it's basically sort of, let's get the outside where you can see her. It's basically a forklift that picks up containers, right? So, yeah. No, I think I need to advance this to the next day, however, before we actually get anything. So, I gotta step out of here. Click over to the next day. And, there we go. Unload a trait. Unload freight from a truck. I know. That should have been really easy to say, huh? Okay, so. WASD to move this little puppy around. No, I don't think the truck's in yet. Whoa! It rolls a little further than the key might imply. Oh, here we go. Check it out. Oh, a whole fleet of trucks. Alright. So, that should about do it. Now, if we use the arrow keys, we can move this up and down. And, oops, we can change the angle of it. A little too much there. If we use the arrow keys with shift, we can somewhat adjust this back and forth, right? So, there we go. A little bit more that way. That looks pretty good. Whoa. Alright, that's not good. Not good at all. Lift, lift, lift. Oh no. There we go. Uh-oh. I don't know where he put that. Oh, no! Yes, I know I damaged that freight. Accidentally knocked it off the truck. Not good, guys. Probably do better. Okay. Okay, now I think I want to rotate a little bit this way. Oops, a bit much. It's really quite touchy. There we go. And then shift, move it over this way a hair. Now, extend the boom. And come over this way a tiny bit. This one's a little different because you, you're not going straight up and down, you have this angle involved. There we go. A little better. Alright, let's lift that up. Pull away, Mr. Truck will leave. And we can put this, since it's going back on a truck, we can put this guy over here. Oh, that looks like our container sitting over there. Okay. That's different. Whoa. A little too quick there, she was starting to spin. There we go, let's move forward just a little. Bit to this side. That should do her. Suck her in a little bit. Tiny bit over, a little more in. Try to set her down. A little more. Perfect. Okay. Now, of course, we have unloaded them both, so we can now click that. See, So it's the 13th, so now we're going to go to our next day. Orders to complete. Oh, we've got to, apparently, they, don't think that's acceptable to leave that other guy over there. So, I mean, fair enough, eh? You know? Fair enough. I mean, we certainly did bollocks it. It is a bit damaged now as well, so. Heavy Tools. I guess that's the company that we are running this contract for. A lot of people chattering about the fact that unlike a true logistics system, a true logistics company, the containers are rather haphazard in so much as every single container in a dockyard or shipping area or whatever they call this one, transshipment point, is going to be numbered as well as just having a company name. These guys, however, are not. That does cause a little bit of a hassle. Because with them not being numbered, once you start getting to where you're having large numbers of containers floating about, because there's also, a little further on into the game, a warehouse. And you have to use a tow motor or a forklift or whatever it is, wherever you're from, to move and sort your containers in the warehouse, i.e. you can end up, I take it, with quite a lot. Of containers in your yard at one point. I mean, the biggest job we saw there from the few we looked at was a train that was going to unload six cars. Six cars isn't a lot. You know, I mean, you look at Transocean and how many containers they were dropping onto our ship, and you can appreciate a little more the kind of numbers you'll eventually end up dealing with. Now, the one thing that I do wonder about is I'm not sure exactly how well this game does that end of things. You know, like once we start getting into a realm of being super, super busy stuff. Ooh, I think I... No, not quite enough. Oh well, should be close enough. Where we've got those sort of worries. Then, I don't know that the game allows any automation in those scenarios. There we go. Now we're finished our day. And so you can end up, I think you may, in the end, having an awful lot of puttering about looking for containers because they're not numbered. Now, apparently when you hover over this or click on it, you see it lights up those containers. And that's how they want you to identify where you exactly are. So, yeah. So basically from this overhead view, you'd click that. And there you go. Ah, there's the containers they want, right? So... I would still like to see a number system. Now we can switch. Oh, not parked in their parking zones. Yes, there we go. Now everybody's parked. We can end our day. So, $567 for the vehicles. And as you see, there's nothing to do today. Now, if we had another contract or two that might want us to be doing things in between, then that's what we'd do, right? But as it is, we are going to whistle through until they tell us that the truck is back. And that should be, I do believe, today. There we are. truck is on the way to the parking lot. Now, we lost that amount of money every day that we were down. Not a big deal from our current 61,000. So then you would go back to your container stacker, of course, and reverse the whole process. Pick up the containers, and when the trucks show up, you would drop them on the trucks. As I say, that's, I think, basically going to cover our second look here. Is that ever off-centered, eh? There we go. Oop, too much. See, as I say, I think that'll basically cover our... Oop, the truck's here. We got to get a move on. Cover our second look. As I said, you also end up reaching a point where you will have a warehouse to manage. And I do believe, I may be wrong, but I believe that might be about it so far. But of course, even that, managing it between those three shipping points can become rather complex. This is the kind of game some people are really going to like it. Some people are going to go, what the heck are you doing? You know? It's relaxing. I'll give it that. You know? And it still requires a little bit of concentration and skill, but without getting to a level of frustration. So, there's our trucks and containers over here. So, but yeah, there you have it, guys. That's been Logistics Company. If you'd like to see a little bit more of this, perhaps as we progress, let me know. I'll be glad to throw a few episodes up. I will continue to play it. I'd like to see where it exactly evolves. And of course, if there's any patches or anything released for it, I'll let you guys know that too. But there you are. That's going to be our first look. So, I'm going to get these loaded back up on the trucks and make my money from them, the however much in dollars it was, 13 grand or something. And hopefully the next time we meet on this series, we'll have billions, absolute billions. So, if you liked it, please leave a comment, leave a like. If you didn't like it, leave a comment, leave an unlike. It's fine. Till next time, take care of each other, folks, and ciao for now.